Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidjar, and Tadakshya Mataraji is Gnostic Trinity and Gospel, video number 16. Here I'm going to give you a touch of spirituality which has been introduced in the first stanza of Japji Sahib, which has all the summary of the whole religious knowledge. If you understand that first stanza, then the whole thing becomes clear to you. So here we are, the once born people, because they are not capable of thinking gospel or pondering over gospel, so to them it is said, Sochya sochna hui je sochi lakhwar, meaning that you can ponder over his word for million times, you will not understand gospel. So, because as Peter, as I said, was with Christ Jesus, but he couldn't understand gospel. And once when he showed him the glimpse of the gospel. So, once born people, they are like stones and they cannot ponder over his word. Then the twice born people who are awakened and they then become clever. So the clever people, they talk too much. They don't stop, you know. Once they start talking, they keep on, you know, like a good salesman, he will keep on praising, you know, his goods, that this, that, that. So they say, it say about that one, chupyan chup na hoi je lai raha livtar. Chupyan chup means that you can't keep quiet. And it is also like the people or the living thing born of the egg. They cannot sit quiet. So that's their characteristic. Then we have the third one, which are sealed to serve God. For them it is bhukhyan bhukhna utri. Meaning that their hunger for the spiritual food is never satisfied. So their food is a spiritual, his word. So as Jesus came to feed his workers with his word, so gospel, so they are pleased to hear his word, and they are never satisfied. Then those people who have become one with God, then their wisdom, worldly wisdom, does not count, because they become the spokesman of God. So about them it is said, sansyam pan lakhon ta ikna chale naal, meaning that howsoever worldly wise the person may be, but none of that counts when you become a spokesman of God. So then you speak what God tells you to speak, not what you like or what your intelligence tells you to do. So that's the first stanza. Then the last verse of that one is, ਸੰਸਿਆ ਪਰਲਖੋਂ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਨਾ ਚੱਲੇ ਨਾਲ ਕਿਵ ਸਚਿਆਰਾ ਹੋਵੀਏ ਕਿ ਕੂੜੇ ਟੁੱਟੇ ਪਾਰ. ਕਿਵ ਸਚਿਆਰਾ ਮੀਨ ਵਾਈ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਵੀ ਬਿਕਮ ਟਰੁੱਥਫੁਲ, ਵਾਈ ਵੀ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਗੋ ਫਾਰ ਦੀ ਵਰਡ ਆਫ ਗੋਡ, ਦੈਟ ਦੀ ਸਾਈਕਲ ਆਫ ਬਰਥ ਐਂਡ ਡੈਥ ਮੇ ਫਿਨਿਸ਼, ਸੋ ਯੂ ਗੈਟ ਸਾਲਵੇਸ਼ਨ, ਯੂ ਬਿਕਮ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਫਾਰ ਐਵਰ, ਯੂ ਬਿਕਮ ਸਨ ਆਫ ਗੋਡ ਐਂਡ ਲਾਈਕ ਫਾਦਰ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਅਟਰਨਲ ਦੈਨ. So that will explain, and now we go to the characteristic, you know, of the people who are of getting education. When you are small boy or children, and they go to the temple to learn moral laws, and those people, rabbis or pandits, they teach them. So when they teach, then you have to reproduce what they teach. So they are called, teaching is of moral law to, we call them Hindus, and in Arabic they call them Jews. So Jews and Hindu, They are the first community of religion. So the rabbi teach them. So most people, they obey what the rabbi tell them to do. That's why Christ Jesus said, do what they tell you to do, but don't follow their example. So they are one who follow the other is a blind person. We haven't seen a person with the eyes following the other. So that's why we call Hindu Anna. Anna means blind. So they just follow their rabbi, as I explained earlier. Then Turku. Turku means one who is awakened, spiritually awakened, but he goes for money. He wants to fleece people. So when he wants to fleece people and become a cheat and dishonest person, we call him a Turku. So those people, the twice born, which are seed to serve God, then they do not cheat anybody. So about them, it is said they are called Gyani. Gyani means those who are knowledgeable. The Gyani people are wiser than both of the first two. The Gyani is wiser than the Hindu and also wiser than the people who are Turku, or who are cheating people. So that's why the people of Gyani or Gurmukh, they are led by Holy Ghost, as explained earlier. So these living things, as we have explained already, the once born, they are represented by vegetation. The twice born, which are of clever mind, they are represented by the living thing born of the eggs, like birds of the air, are all that they have strong sensory organs, so they can collect the information very quick. Then the born of the placenta are the people who can think logically. And then we have the fourth one, the celestial world, which is universal self. That means those people, they can adopt any self to help the devotees to perform their duties. So they can take flesh, any animal shape or man, human shape or whatever they can, you know, adopt any shape. Then we have the characteristic spiritual states, which we said was ego or id, which we call home, mind, we call it man, twice born, and then the twice born which are sealed, we call it wisdom or buddhi. And those who are of the celestial world, one with God, they are led by will or chitvirti. So whatever they will, that is done. So people of the first once born, they are being not understand, they can't understand the gospel, they are called bemukh. Bemukh means that they do not understand the thing. Manmukh means who uses his own cleverness. Gurmukh means one who goes by the will of God. The God is the Gur for them. So whatever his will, he will do. He becomes the mouthpiece of God. Then we have communities which are Hindu for the once born, for twice born, which have awakened mind, we call it Sikh, and in Middle East we call Christian. And then we have the seal to serve God, philanthropists, they are called Khalsa or Musliman. Then those who are one with God are saints and apostles, they are called Arif in Arabic and Sant in Punjabi and in saint in English. So in the next video, that would be a hope last, then we start our Bible exposition of Matthew. Thank you for listening, and wait for the next one.